You know, there are a lot of people who have never heard the gospel of Christ. And somehow I have a little bit of trouble sometimes when I see people spending 15, 16 bucks a hit to hear some flashy Christian group say Jesus is Lord to the tune of 15 bucks a person. When there are people who live not far from here who can't even afford to buy a Bible. And somehow it seems a little bit weird that we should have more ministers in this country and fewer people, when in the world where there are so many people who would give anything to have a minister, they can't find them because they're not there, because they're in our country. I don't believe that God chose you and blessed you so that you could heap those blessings up upon yourself. I believe God chose you and you and you and every one of you others because He wants to make a difference in this world. And you know what? What I think is scary about God is He didn't come up with any plan B. That He left the church here, and the church is the only group of people, and the church is the only institution in the world that can bring about a change. This government cannot do it. So stop depending on the government. Educational systems cannot do it, so stop trusting educational systems. The church was chosen by God to make a difference. And you know what, people? You ain't going to make a difference by building more bombs. And you ain't going to make a difference by putting on more makeup and showing up on more television shows. And you're not going to make a difference by having the loudest PA or the biggest crowd at your concerts. You're going to make a difference when you lay down your life and in complete submission to God, choose to die with Him in service to other people. There's a laid me down one evening, thought of Jesus on the hill. How for man he was weeping when it was him they were going to kill. And I know he would have saved them had they only just allowed him. None is stronger than the humble if you are weaker than the proud. Did my thoughts return to David, how he watched his father's flock, how the music that he was a-playing, it calmed the demons, a mighty man's heart. And when the prophet came round looking for a king, well, he sought young David out. None is stronger than the humble, if you are weaker than the proud. And I know that you know about Moses, how he left the Pharaoh's courts when he saw the injustice done to the people. The people of the Lord, though his fears drove him to hiding, the Lord his heart with courage soon endowed. There's none as stronger than the humble, if you are weaker than the proud. And none as stronger than the humble, you are weaker than proud.